Welcome to the community of
engineers, the change agents in the society. In this video, factors affecting the intensity of solar radiation falling on surface of the earth for a particular location and time would be highlighted. The probable influencing factors are types of the solar radiations, albedo of the earth, air mass, earth's rotation, earth's revolution, and tilt of the earth. As we know, the main source of energy is sun. The energy comes from the sun due to continuous fusion reaction of hydrogen combining to form helium, resulting in loss of mass about 0.0276 atomic mass unit. This loss of mass releases energy of 25.7 million electron volt. The rate of conversion according to Einstein's expression E is equal to mc square, where 1 atomic mass unit is equal to 1.6604 × 10⁻²⁴ gram, and the speed of light is 2.998 × 10⁻¹⁰ centimeter per second. Thus, the energy produced by one atomic mass unit would be equal to 1 electron volt, or in 1 million electron volt, which is 1.602 × 10⁻³⁰ joule. Here the energy release of 25.7 million electron volt by forming one helium appears to be very small, but the fusion reactions are taking place in plenty per second. So the energy release is enormous. And the fraction of energy intercepted by the sun is only 4.5 × 10⁻¹⁰. This energy comes to the earth in the form of radiations. The amount of energy received at the earth's surface is approximately 1367 watt per meter square, which is known as solar constant. Further, the solar radiations approximately contains 7% is the range of greater than 0 and less than 0.38 microns, which we call the ultraviolet range. 47% falls in the range of greater than 0.38 and less than 0.78 micron, that is the visible range, and about 46% greater than 0.78 microns, which is the infrared range. Solar radiation received at the Earth's surface is mostly in the range of greater than 0.29 and less than 4 microns. Diffused radiation. Solar radiation during its passage in the atmosphere gets partly absorbed in the atmosphere and then scattered or reflected back in the atmosphere. Radiation which gets reflected, absorbed, or scattered is not completely lost in the atmosphere and comes back on surface of the earth, which is known as the diffused radiation. Direct or beam radiation, as the name implies, is the amount of solar radiation received at any place on the earth directly from the sun without any disturbance. Or solar radiation which reaches on the earth's surface without being scattered by the atmosphere. Global or total radiation, which is the sum of the diffuse and direct radiation on surface of the earth. Reflected radiation, shortwave radiation reflected from other surfaces. Reflected radiation is mainly reflected from the terrain and is therefore more important in mountainous areas. Albedo. It is a measure of how much radiation is reflected by a surface. Its value ranges between 1 to 0. When the albedo is 1, all radiation is reflected, none is absorbed. When the albedo is 0, no radiation is reflected, it is all absorbed. Satellite measurements made since the late 1970s estimate Earth's average albedo to be about 0.33. In other words, about 67% of incoming solar radiation is reflected back into the space and 33% is absorbed. Air mass. The strand of radiation depletion at any given time depends on the length of travel of the sun rays through the atmosphere. The ratio of the mass of atmosphere through which the beam radiation passes to the mass it would pass through if the sun were at zenith means directly overhead. When the sun is vertically above a location, the sunlight takes the shortest path through the atmosphere. In space, Earth moves in different ways. One way the Earth moves by spinning on its axis. The axis is an imaginary line runs through the center of the Earth. The two end points through which the axis passes is known as North Pole and South Pole. As the Earth rotates, part of the Earth is facing the Sun. This part of the Earth lit up by solar radiation and experience our daytime. At the same time, the opposite side of the Earth is facing away from the Sun. This part of the Earth is in darkness and experience our nighttime. Earth rotates west to east and one complete revolution takes 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4.09 seconds, roughly counted as 24 hours. The speed of the Earth's rotation at the equator is 1,670 kilometers per hour. Earth also revolves around the Sun in an elliptical orbit known as revolution of the Earth. The Earth revolves at an average speed of 29.8 km per second. Earth completes one revolution in 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes and 45.51 seconds, but roughly taken as 365 days, 6 hours. Further, the axis of the Earth is tilted at 23.45 degrees from the vertical. Due to the tilt of the Earth, the length of the day and night varies location to location. Further, to find out any location on the Earth is marked with latitudes and longitudes. Consequently, in consideration of various motions of the Earth, the solar radiation falling on surface per unit area of the surface would depend on the location of the Earth, the time of the day and the day of the year.